Hello and welcome again to my channel. This is your girl Favour and you're welcome to another episode of From the Heart with Favour. So if this is your first time seeing my face or any of my videos, you are welcome. In fact, make us sing for you. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. I can see all over you the glory of the Lord. You are welcome in the name of the Lord. I believe this little rendition of mine is enough to make you subscribe. Don't mind me. Please make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell that comes up after to get notifications whenever I post new videos. And to my returning subscribers, you know I heart you. You know I love you. So thank you for returning always to watch my videos, for the likes, for the shares. I thank you. So let's get serious. Onto the matter for the day. So today we are discussing putting God aside. Sounds weird, yeah? Sit tight and let's get right to this video. So, yeah, I said today we are discussing putting God aside. This is an expression I have heard countless times. And funny enough, I hear it also from Christians, those that are supposed to be children of God. So they say, we are probably discussing something and they be like, just put God aside, let's stop what? So if you put God aside, what will you mean? That's what I always ask. If you say let us put God aside, okay, when we have put God aside, what will you mean? But seriously, you called yourself a child of God and you're saying let's put God aside. God is present. God should be present. If you, once you are a child of God, God should be recognized in every aspect of your life, in every of your discussions, in every of your thoughts, in every of your words. God should be recognized. So I don't see a reason why somebody would say let's put God aside. Really? When you put aside the center of a thing, when you remove the center of a thing, where is the balance? As a child of God, your balance, the center of you is supposed to be Christ. So when you put God aside, oh yeah, where is the balance? So where is your balance? Where is your balance when you put the center of you aside? That is if Christ is the center of you, because I don't see why you would say put God aside if Christ is really in the center of you, or the center of you, or the center of your personality, your person, your entirety, your identity. I don't see why you would say put God aside. Because the reason why I'm discussing this topic is because I've heard it a lot of times. Whenever I hear it, it breaks my heart. Especially when I hear it from Christians. Who is a Christian? A Christian is someone that behaves like Christ. A Christian is someone that is Christ-like, a child of God. If I'm to, yeah, a child of God. Because let's see, like, am I even going into Bible teaching, Bible class now? But we all know how the name Christian came about. So if you are a Christian, you are supposed, that means you are a child of God. Not, Christianity is not a religion, it's a way of life. So we have heard that a lot of times. So I think I'm even going into Bible class. Let me come back. Yeah, so once you're a child of God, your center is supposed to be Christ. Christ is supposed to be in the center of you. It's supposed to, everything you do, everything you say, every of your decisions stems from the word of God, stems from Christ. So if you say put this person that is the center of you aside, where is your balance? What are you going to be discussing? What are you going to be analyzing or illustrating that you put the center of that thing aside? Or the center of you aside? So you want to lose balance because you want to discuss what? And the complete sentence is this. Let's put God aside and face reality. Okay, you are a child of God, so you have called yourself a child of God, so what is your reality supposed to be? your reality is the Word of God. As long as you are a child of God, your reality is the Word of God. But I think the reason why people even mention this, because for them to mention it, they thought it. So for someone to say it, that person does not really know his or her identity. Because if you know your identity, you know that your reality is in the Word of God, that your reality is Christ, is in Christ. If your identity is in Christ, your reality is in His Word, is in what He has told you to do. So I think what we should first do is to understand our identity. If you can spell out your identity, if you know for real who you are, you will not say put you aside. You will not say put that identity of yours aside. So if you put your identity aside, then who are you? So why say put God aside and face reality? If you put God aside, where you won't go? If you say face reality, well, what is your reality? Because we have so not understood our identity that we let the world set the standards for us. And that is what we see now in the church. It seems like the world is setting the standard for everything. The way you should look, the way you should talk, the way you should carry yourself, where you should go, how you should appear. The world seems to be setting the standard. That is because a lot of us do not understand who we are. A lot of us have not clearly understood our identity. If you understand your identity, you would know that your reality is in Christ. So what reality, what other reality are you facing? What other reality do you want to face? If you say, let's put God aside and face reality. This thing, it breaks my heart. It really does break my heart when I hear people say this. Sometimes in the comment section, like when I probably say something and then someone will be like, put God aside and this, where, what, who, like, put, oh God. Why would you want to put God aside? Why? This is supposed to be a really short video, so I'll just keep it simple and short. So next time, if you want to say that, or you think it, first of all, define who you are. If you have called yourself a child of God, define what your relationship with God is. First of all, understand who you are. And where your reality or where your identity is before you say, let's face reality. Whose child are you? So who is setting the standard for you? Whose reality? Who is saying this is your reality? That is why a whole lot of things happen to us. Because we don't understand who we are. That is why it seems like the devil is fighting you in a particular area of your life. Because you don't understand who you are. The moment you understand who you are, trust me, the devil will hands off. He has no problem with you going to church, but he has a problem with you understanding who you are. I know you might have had that a lot, but take it into consideration. The enemy does not have problem with you going to church or listening to messages or even reading the Bible, but his problem is in you believing that which you have heard, believing that which you have read. If you are a child of God, you should believe the Word, and the Word is your reality. The Word of God is your reality. I seem to be going here and there with this topic, but yes. What is your identity? Because I think this is an identity issue. For someone to say put God aside, for a child of God, for someone that has called him or herself a child of God to say put God aside and face reality, the person doesn't fully understand who he is or who she is. The person has not recognized God as the center of him or the center of her. Am I speaking? Okay, yeah. If Christ is the center of all that you do, of all that you say, of all your decisions, all your footsteps, then you should know that you cannot put him aside in whatever it is you are analyzing or discussing or illustrating or explaining. So let's be wise. Let us not let the enemy confuse us. Don't let the enemy blind you to the truth that God is showing you. The truth about you is in the Word of God. The truth about you is in Christ. So you cannot put him aside. And with that, I've come to the end of this video. Remain blessed and please make sure to subscribe if you have not subscribed and give us a thumbs up if you like this video. Please make sure to comment and share this video to your loved ones, to everyone you believe should hear this. And until next time, I'll see you. God bless you.